blow down in boiler. Now we are going to see about what is meant by blow down in boiler, what are the importance of the blow down, what we want to carry out, what will happen if blow down is not happened in the boiler, what are types of blow down, when need to contact blow down operation, and blow down calculations, how much quantity, how much flow rates we want to maintain in order to sustain the steam and the water quality and better efficiency in the boiler. So in boiler, water is continuously getting heating up and then steam generation is happening. Due to that, what will happen? The dissolved solids in the water will be remains as such in the water, and water will get evaporate to form steam. So automatically, the concentration of the dissolved solids in that water will get increased, and in certain stage exceed their solubility, and there is a scale formation in the heating surface. In the boilers, the heating surface mainly the tubes, water wall tubes, superheated tubes. And then the steam drums, mud drum. In those areas, the scale formation will be happen. And what will happen? The scale is get formed in the surface. Then the heat transfer will get reduced due to its resistance of the scales. So localized heating will occur, and which causes the tubes failure. To avoid that, there is a standards how much concentration of the solids we want to maintain in the boiler. ASME standard is there, and the boiler vendor itself, they have the certain parameters how much we can maintain. They will give. We want to maintain that concentrations. So after the certain conditions, if you not maintain the level of concentration, there is a possibility of the solid carryover to the steam. So which will causes the scale deposition in the pipelines, and even though it can carry over to the turbines also, turbine blades also. So, and will reduce the turbine efficiency also. So, it is the important role. We want to maintain the blow down operation. So, what we want to do to avoid the concentrations of the solids inside the boiler, we want to get bleed off the water, and we want to add the makeup. That's it. That we want to do to avoid this. So, for maintaining the water quality, if we do the blow down enormous, there will be the losses, because the heated up water we are going to bleed off, drain to maintain the certain quantity prescribed by the vendor of the boiler or the as per the standards. So it should be optimum. So there are the two types of blowdown normally. One is the continuous blowdown operation, and another is the intermittent blowdown operation. Continuous blowdown, nothing but it will be bleed off and continuous discharge from the steam drum in order to maintain the specified water quality and the steam quantity in the boiler. So what are the parameters normally we will measure in the steam generator, steam and then brought on water? pH, conductivity, TDS, silica, phosphate, sulfate, these are the major parameters need to monitor. So in boiler, where we will make a continuous blowdown. So continuous blowdown, it will be from the steam drum. This is the typical steam drum in the boiler. So these are the water wall tubes projected in the steam drum. It is welded in that. This is the feed water pipe. So this is the continuous blowdown pipe. It is a perforated pipe, that is holes. Many holes will be there. So this line will be connected to the drain system and it will go to the flash drum, the continuous blowdown. You're not able to directly drain it off, right? We want to flash it out because it will be the steam drum pressure will be there. And the return, it will go to the waste pit. Normally the flash steam will be used to the system when the steam quality is good. Otherwise, this steam quality also will get affect the other systems because this continuous blowdown concentration is more whenever. So this is line. The wall opening will be the constant throughout the operation. 24 hours operation. 24 hours it will be open. There will not change it. Whenever there is the changes in the feed water quality or the steam quality, so we want to adjust based on the calculation. That we will going to see how to calculate the blowdown rate. This is the plug. Whenever the tubes get leaked during the hydro, that time we will plug it out. So it is there, I'm telling you. Next, intermittent blowdown. Intermittent blowdown means after there is a continuous blowdown operation also, sometimes we're not able to sustain the parameter which is required. This is TDS or conductivity, silica, phosphate, sulfate, we're not able to maintain, or the pH we're not able to maintain means we want to bleed off a certain quantity of the boiler water to sustain the water and the steam quality. So this is called intermittent blowdown. Intermittent blowdown, normally it will be operate once in 8 hours. In the worst case, once in the 4 hours also will be there. So based on the quality achievement, it will be not a continuous operation. So it will be come from the lowest part of the boiler. That is from the mud drum, we'll see. It is a mud drum. From here, there will be the drain line will be there. Through that, we will operate. So that wall will be not continuously full open. It will be throttled during the operation. Based on the requirement, it will be get vary. So now, I think it will be clear. So now we know the importance of the blowdown operations in order to maintain the water quality as per the standards, to avoid the scale deposition in the boiler tubes and in the outlet pipelines and the outlet line. It should be also optimum to avoid the more energy losses through the blowdown. And the two types, one is the continuous, one is the intermittent. Continuous blowdown will be automatically, it will be continuously, it will be open condition and a certain wall opening. And it will be taken from the steam drum. And intermittent blowdown, it will be the lower part of the boiler, especially in the mud drum. So whenever required, we will be the open the intermittent blowdown wall and we will maintain the fluid for a certain time and we will close it back for the 2 minutes or 4-5 minutes operation. So how to calculate the blowdown? So what are the parameters required? How many TDS we will take? It is a typical methodology for calculating the blowdown. So TDS we want to measure in the feed water analysis. In our feed water, it is 1 ppm only. It is a good quality of the water. So in our case, we consider that is a 50 kg per centimeter square of the steam drum operation. But it is required to maintain as per the standard. We taken 100 ppm as vendor recommended 100 ppm, so we taken 100 ppm. But as per the standards, we can maintain up to 150, 200, 250. We can maintain that, but for better operation and for the better efficient operations, so we consider it as the 100. And TDS in the steam. Steam that normally for the sampling there will be some condensation. From that we will take the steam sample. After condensation, from that we can measure the TDS. So in our case it is 0.1 ppm. And the steam output flow rate, that is evaporation rate of the boiler, it is 85 tons per hour. And feed water flow rate is 86 tons per hour. It can more also based on the blowdown, based on the steam blasts. So we've taken a typical example in that. And formula derivation, how to derive the formula. Normally we know the mass balance. So feed water we are giving to the boiler, which is equal to steam output plus blowdown rate. Losses, steam loss is not there in the typical case. So we're not considered in that. Steam leakage there will be not considered. So F is the feed water flow rate. FT is the TDS of the feed water. It is normal mass balance only. It is a steam outlet flow rate into steam TDS plus blowdown rate into blowdown TDS. So we don't know the blowdown rate. We want to calculate that one. So we kept in the RHS side, right hand side, RHS. And the main thing we move to the LHS, left hand side. So F into FT minus S into ST will be there. So blowdown B is equal to F into FT minus S into ST divided by whole divided by BT will be there. So here feed water rate is, we can multiply it. Feed water rate is 86 into TDS of the feed water is 0.1 ppm minus steam flow rate is 85 into steam TDS is 0.1. So it is 1, right? So I put the 0.1. It is 1. So this divided by what is the blowdown TDS we want to maintain, that is 100 ppm we can maintain. So divided by 100. So we will get the blowdown rate. So 0.775, that is around 1 tons per hour we want to give the blowdown to maintain the 100 ppm TDS. So we can take this TDS as a typical, we can take the conductivity also, the silicate or phosphate, whatever may be the constraints. Normally we will consider the TDS as a standard metallurgy, standard calculations.